Well, we had some exciting news yesterday in Dallas, Texas.
Yeah, we did.
This is probably the best ending to a car chase I have ever seen. And I lived in California for like 23 years. I feel like California has them all. No, this is the best by far.
Uh-huh.
Meet Jessica Liesmann.
Hi, Jessica Liesmann.
This is a superhero.
You're the star of the car chase video.
Supermom. Oh my God.
No, she is Mama Bear. That's what everybody's calling you now after this video made national news, international news at this point.
I can't believe it. Oh, my God.
Are you still shaking? Can you believe what you did when you step back and look at the video?
I mean, given the situation, I can.
Yeah.
You know, but seeing it is a different thing. I'm like, oh, my God.
So you're sitting at a red light, apparently.
Yes. Well, back up.
Unbeknownst to you, there's a police chase going on that had been
going on
for miles.
We heard the helicopters and everything, and I'm figuring maybe it's just a car wreck on the highway.
Right.
You know, stuff like that happens all the time here.
And you don't think it's going to get to you, right?
No, never.
There had been a carjacking at gunpoint. So this was an armed man who was being chased by police. And unfortunately for you, he came up behind your car and hit it at an intersection where you were stopped.
Yep. And the whole thing was, is that, you know, you're in a school zone. You're supposed to be going 20 miles.
That's right.
So that's what made you mad at first.
Yeah, that's what made me so angry.
Yeah.
Because you didn't even know there was a police chase going on. You
just knew I had no idea.
A car just smacked you from the rear
end. In a school zone, Al.
Yeah.
So think about it. I drive in that school zone every single day and witness cars just speeding through there. I see kids walking down the street, and I'm like, what if one of those kids trips and falls out?
Right.
You know, on the sidewalk, and you're just flying through here. You know, you're going to run over that kid.
Right.
So I already get angry about, you know, speeders in school zones. I really do.
Right. So the first impact, what's your first reaction? Because your son, your
12-year-old. Yeah, I turned around. The first thing I did was turn around. I said, hey, you okay? Are you okay?
To your son.
Yeah. And he said, I'm fine. I didn't see any blood. So I jumped out of the car.
Your mom, you'll be right back.
I just charged at him. I'm like, what are you thinking? What's wrong with you?
What's he doing?
You know, I said more than that.
So was your plan just to give him like a stern talking to?
Yeah. I wanted to ask him what is wrong. What's your problem? Because he hit me really hard.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, and you don't hit that hard if you're going even 30 miles an hour.
Right. No, and he's starting to try to get out of the car, and you do the ninja kick at that point.
He wasn't fixing to go anywhere.
Were you thinking he was going to get out and maybe harm you, or you were thinking he was going to run away?
The only thing on my mind was that he was going to run.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
So the only instinct I had was grab him.
Okay.
Grab him. You're not going anywhere.
And you got a good grip.
He had on some great overalls.
Yeah. A tip for the carjackers out there. Don't wear overalls because Jessica can hold on to you with no problem.
What's a thief doing wearing overalls?
I don't.
At one point, your boyfriend intervened. Were you like, I got this?
Yeah. If it wasn't for him, he wouldn't have got taken down to the ground. I would have been walking him like he was a dog or something. But I would have just been running behind him holding on to his suspenders. I had a death grip. He wasn't going anywhere. Yeah. But
now he
took him down.
Your son got out of the car as well.
Yeah.
And he sat down on the curb.
Oh, God.
And then he started.
You've seen the video. Of course, you've seen the video.
I asked him. I said, what are you doing right here?
He's writhing around.
Yeah, he said, I didn't know what to do. He was like, I didn't know what to do, so I just fell out. He was like, I didn't know what to do.
My mama's over there kicking some man's ass.
He's rolling around.
Oh. That's why I'm telling you, Jessica, when they ask your son, because you guys are going to keep getting interviewed about this, because this is the number one story now.
Yeah.
You tell your son to answer this way. Say, I just felt like breakdancing. You know, sometimes you just got to do an impromptu breakdance.
I knew there was a news camera on me, so I just wanted to dance.
I know. So you think your Can Dance is about to start a new season, and I wanted to join.
And when they were interviewing your boyfriend and your son, they weren't really surprised by your reaction. So have you actually gotten this angry before in another situation?
Just when it comes to my family and my kids,
protective.
Yeah, very, very protective. It's gotten worse since my son passed away and my mom passed away. I have very few family members left, and they mean everything to me.
You protect that little boy with everything you have because you lost your son last year, right? Your 4-year-old son.
And I still have a 6-year-old daughter as well. Thank God she was not in the car. You know, because she's
He'd
little
be dead.
You would have flipped the car over, probably.
I don't know what I would do.
I tell you, the most touching thing is just at the end when the guys on the ground, the police are there, and you're just standing behind the car holding your son. Everybody that's commenting just like, we're all crying because it's just a mother's love.
Yeah.
And you'll do anything to protect them. And we all would hope that we would have that same
spitfire
in us.
You know, the majority of mamas that really genuinely love and care for their kids would have did the same thing.
Yeah. I mean, the courage you showed, although I'm sure the police officers would tell you, don't do that in the future.
Right.
Absolutely.
But the courage you showed was beyond words. And Can you tell us what you felt when you saw the playback of the video? Because you were at the hospital, right?
Oh, my gosh, yeah. I was sitting on the floor because I was shaking so bad that I didn't want to sit in a chair because my knees were doing like that. So I sat on the floor to kind of control the shaking, and I was watching the TV, but I was on my phone for, you know, I was messaging people, like, you know, what happened. And then my son was like, "Mom, you're on TV." I was like, "Oh my God. Oh my God.
That's me."
Yeah, like I just was like, "Oh my God. Like I look so violent." You know, you don't see how you look until you actually see yourself.
Right.
Oh,
and
wow.
You're like, "And why did I wear that outfit?"
Yeah. Well, I had just got off of work, so
right.
That's my excuse for that one.
Yeah, so you're and that's when you found out later that the guy had a gun.
Oh my God, when I found that out, my heart hit my stomach.
Yeah.
The bottom of my stomach. I was like, "Oh my God, this could have been so
how
much
it
worse.
Gone.
I could have, you know." I rethink the situation now. I'm just glad it played out the way
it
did.
Oh, it played out perfectly for you.
Well, it didn't play out too perfectly. Your car is not even drivable right now.
It's just a car.
What kind of shape is it in?
High five on that, girl.
Yeah, right.
It is. It's just a car.
He hit it pretty hard. What, is it totaled, you know, or is it fixable?
I don't know. I don't think it's totaled because none of my airbags deployed.
Okay.
Yeah. That looked pretty bad.
Well, somebody obviously thinks that you, in the situation, you know, your car is undrivable right now.
Right.
It's probably going to be impounded for the investigation or whatever.
It's in the impound. The only thing that I'm upset about, my car being taken, is because I have things that belong to my son.
Yeah.
Like
that
what?
Passed away. I have his stroller back there. And
they won't let you get any of
toys.
That?
I don't know. I haven't called them. Mm. It's just, you know, how am I going to get there?
Yeah. So, Jessica, man, you've had a 24 hours that have just been out of this world crazy for you.
Yes.
So I got on the phone with a buddy of mine that owns a car dealership down the street. His name is Bill Dickerson. The name of the dealership is Southwest Kia. I want to make sure I give him a good plug. I said, "Bill, your motto is, if I can't give you a better deal, I'll just give you the car." I said, "What kind of deal can you give me on a car?" And he told me, and I just bought you a car.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
Are you serious?
I just bought you a car.
What? God.
Yes, from Southwest Kia.
You bought her a car?
I just bought her a car.
You wait, like you paid and stuff?
I paid and stuff.
Oh, my God.
We don't even believe him right now. Wait, what?
I don't know what's going on.
Wait.
Are you serious?
I bought the woman a car.
Did you get it from the carjacker?
No.
Oh,
you bought the car?
I didn't steal you a car. I bought you a car.
Thank you so much.
Wait to make the rest of us look bad.
Well, you gave me $100 on GoFundMe.
Jessica,
so that's cool.
I bought you flowers.
That's very nice, too.
You know?
I can hook you up with Sherry's Berries.
Pro flowers.
Oh, my God. You are so nice. Thank you.
Oh, absolutely. You've been through a lot. And
oh,
now,
my God.
I haven't made a woman cry in years.
Well, not in a
good way. Yeah, you have.
In a good way. Right.
What a nice surprise,
Al.
Yeah.
See, forget
Thank
that
you.
Van, Jessica. Don't even get it fixed.
Don't even worry about it. In fact, let me have that. I'll take that on trade.
You know, if you hadn't have said Al was your favorite, none of this would have happened.
Oh my God.
That was smart on your part.
How do you feel right now, Jessica?
My eyes are burning because I'm crying.
Oh, it's okay.
Yeah, you have to do is whoop some bad guy's butt.
Oh my God, I just cannot believe this. It's amazing. Thank you so much. You are a blessing to
me. What's this mean to you and your family?
A lot. Now we don't have to worry about public transportation or school buses. Thank you.
You're welcome.
Very much. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you,
Southwest
Kia.
You saved us a lot of...
You might have to hold a check for a couple of days.
Nice of you, Al.
That was... Okay, can I come give you a hug?
Yes. Hell yeah, give him a hug.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome. You're welcome. And you're going to be my personal bodyguard from now on.
Oh, wow.
I want you to get every amenity.
I mean, we're talking about seat warmers.
I want two DVD players.
Oh, yeah.
You got two kids.
You got two kids.
Yeah.
Oh, my
God. Oh, you know what? Get two air conditioners just in case one goes out.
One for inside the car, one for outside the
car. Definitely a rear view camera.
And you know what? But get a big enough car to where you can have four spare tires because you never know if all four are going to blow out at one point.
Yeah.
And y'all not helping me at all.
Well, we're just so happy that everything worked out, that you're safe, that your son is safe, and hey, you're getting a fancy new ride out of it.
I can't believe that.
Yeah, right? Yeah.
Thank you so much for coming on. Jessica Liesmann, Mama Bear.
Yeah.
Thank you.